Hey, horse people. Man, it was like 8 degrees wind chill. Got down earlier this morning. When I looked at it, it was like 16 degrees with 8 degree wind chill. So that's kind of nippy for Texas, especially since it was like 72 or 73 a few days ago. Buddy just saw me, heard me talking. He's like, I just gave him some carrots and an apple apiece. When they're separated, I can give Mr. T a little more, and Buddy won't hog it. So when I see them on different sides of the fence, I usually bring them little snacks, and Mr. T gets more. You notice Buddy, he's not really eating any of this excess hay that I have laid out there. He's out there nibbling on the fresh green grass coming up. So because he's younger and he gets more nutrition when he's eating, because he probably chews his hay better, he doesn't eat as much as Mr. T. And Mr. T used to be a really easy keeper. And he would just put on weight and be kind of fat all the time. And as he's getting up there in age, I don't know, 27, 28, something like that, his hips are a little sunken in, and he eats because he probably doesn't chew as good. Maybe he doesn't get as much nutrition. His body doesn't process it the same. He has to eat more than Buddy, which is why I usually like to throw a little extra more so Buddy can't pick it and eat it. Until it's all icy where the sprinklers are on over there. But anyway, I talk about the different. Everybody's always asked me, how much do you feed? It depends. When you're getting horses, it depends on their age, how well they process. Are they easy keepers? Are they hard? Are they doing a lot of exercise? Mr. T's, they're not doing much. They're just kind of hanging around. But he's been at that same pile. And I threw that out last night, 2 flakes. And they nibbled on it through the night. And I threw a couple flakes over here in case they went to the other side. And they nibbled on it. And then in the morning, I usually give them a flake of alfalfa. It was about 4:30 this morning when I was giving them their alfalfa because it was cold. And I figured I was up anyway. So I went out there and threw in some alfalfa just to give them warming up. Because, the early morning, it's always coldest early in that morning because it's been dark. The earth's been losing heat all night. So anyway, let me get Buddy's close-up so I don't get in trouble by his agent. There's Buddy's close-up. All right, we're done with Buddy. We're talking about feeding old guys and understanding. So look, every time I talk about horses and stuff, I there's not an easy answer. And people that ask easy questions tell me they don't understand horses. Because when you're new to horses, you're like, you want yes or no's, you want right and wrongs. And it always depends. And it's like legal issues on my cop channel where I talk about guns and legal issues and stuff with the law and court and all that. It always depends. Totality of circumstances is a legal term we use a lot in police work because you can't judge something in a vacuum. You can't go, this guy stole a candy bar. Does he go to prison? Does he not go to? It depends. Did he use force? Did he force? Did he fight somebody for it? Did he use a weapon? What's his prior history? So there's all these factors. So that's why it's always totality of circumstances. Well, with horses, it's kind of the same way. People go, how much do I feed my horse? It depends. What's his age? Is he an easy keeper? Does he have fresh grass available? Do you feed him once or twice a day? Are you feeding rich food or cheap food? Do you have somebody else feed him? Because when you board your horse and you have them buy food, they normally buy the cheapest food. They don't want to feed your horse. They don't want all their profits going to feed your horse. That's why I don't like people feeding my horses. I want to buy hay. I smell my hay. I look at the richness of the hay, the color, Was it cut? Is it damp? Is it dry? Is it old? I'm still feeding hay that's been in my barn for 2 years. But because it's been in there and they didn't eat it, I kind of give them a flake of the old hay, and then I give them a flake of this year's hay that was cut. And then they get to pick and choose on which one they want. Do they like some hay better? Yeah. Is your alfalfa 3 years old? Has it been sitting in the sun and it's all sun bleached? Or is it fresh, green, and really leafy with a lot of nutrients? All of that depends, and it's totality of circumstances. So there's no easy answer. For those that ask the questions and want easy answers, they tell me they don't know. And the people that give them easy answers and say, always, never, oh, you have to do this, you're doing it wrong, that tells me they don't know. I get a lot of heat on my gun channel because they say, you're always changing your opinion. You're not consistent. I'm not consistent because my opinion changes when I get more facts, which is why I don't like answering questions when people go, I need to fix my horse. How can I fix your horse? I don't know what your knowledge is. I don't know what you do. I don't know who handles your horse. I don't know what equipment you use. How was your horse trained? How often you visit it? Are you trying to train it 1 hour a month, or do you spend time? Do you understand pressure and release, or you don't? Do you say you understand? I'm about to do a video on some dude talking about pressure and release. He ain't got a damn clue on pressure and release. But I forgot what it was, Michigan Training or something. Some guy sent it to me, or some woman sent it to me. I don't know. I open an email, and they go, man, you got to look at his video on what he did wrong. And I went, holy cow, this guy's an idiot. But he's got probably a lot of people following him. He's got videos on YouTube. So, you know, but he's deciding to come in. So, see, he went out, and he kind of grazed on some green grass, and now he came back. Choices. Choices are always best for horses. You know, I put that pond in out there because I wanted to give my horse choices about water. I feed him for it. She just found a little carrot that was out there. I don't know if you guys saw that. He didn't see it, poor old man. That's why I can't feed him around Buddy, because Buddy sees it and eats it. He can't even see it. Before he even sees it, Buddy's already eating it. And somebody asked about his tail being sideways. You know, I noticed that too. I don't know why he's holding his tail. Sometimes they'll hold their tail up when they're passing gas. Sometimes when he's walking, he holds it to one side. I don't know if he's got a pinched nerve, he's got a little pain, if he's crampy. I don't know. I don't notice him being gassy when I'm around him. But he's deciding to probably go get a drink. He usually drinks out of the pond. Buddy will drink out of the warm water with the little heater. But Mr. T usually walks down to the pond and get a drink. So where is he going? I don't know. He's getting his exercise and walking. And he may be coming around to see Buddy. But when I saw him having different eating patterns, I was like, well, I say the same thing a lot, but sometimes when I see different examples, I like to reinforce it. Again, I'm not into pushing my way of horses. That's not really what I'm about. I mean, people say that. Oh, he hates women. He just wants to push his man ways. Whatever. I really want people to be able to critical think. And in this day and age, everybody is so busy picking a side and sticking with their side that they're not open to critical thinking, critical evaluation, and questioning what they do and why they do it. And just because it's popular, don't make it right. And just because a lot of people don't like it doesn't make it wrong. You have to be able to critical think and evaluate. And when it comes to horses, there's a thing called horse sense. And used to be everybody had horse sense. To me, horse sense and common sense are pretty close. And they don't teach kind of common sense. You don't have to think anymore. You got red lights. You don't have to look before you cross the street. You go to school. Everything's handed to you. We got to have 14 different ways. We've dumbed down society so much that nobody has to think anymore. And so then you lose common sense. And when you lose common sense, you lose horse sense. Buddy must see Mr. T coming up. I bet you if I go over here, Mr. T. Let me walk around here. You can watch Buddy. I'll see if Mr. T's coming. Yeah, see, old Mr. T went to go get a drink. I'll bring it over here. So Buddy saw him walk around the corner and go, dude, that's my friend. What's old Mr. T doing? He's getting an old drink. He decided to come around, grab a little drink, and now he's going to walk around and see Buddy. So, anyway, I would like this channel to be a continuing education and reminder. Don't get set in your ways. Don't think you're always right. Don't think you know more than a horse. Try and think like a horse. When your horse does something, there's usually a reason. Whether they're smelling, whether they're fear, whether there's something changed in the environment. I mean, you know, they say animals know when earthquakes comes before they come. They can sense it. I don't know if that's true, but I do think they're a little bit more connected to survival. So I figured Mr. T go over there and eat with Buddy, but he looks like he doesn't. Well, maybe he will. He's kind of giving him the eye. Maybe he's giving him an eye trying to draw Buddy in to him. he might pull Buddy off that hay. See, I kind of walked and he kind of flanked over to him, but he wasn't going to the hay. So I wonder if he was trying to create a draw to tell Buddy to follow him. Buddy's like, dude, I was already down there. I already ate all the good little green grass down there. So Mr. T got a little exercise. He's kind of eating right where Buddy was eating earlier. And I didn't throw any food down there, but there must be a little patch of green grass that they found tasteful. I moved the camera this way and he moved the other way. He knows I'm filming him. Little shit, he never wants to be in camera. Mr. T's like, I ain't got no damn contractor agent. Don't be filming me. So he must have found a little bit of grass, or he's just kind of sniffing and eating those little sprouts I was talking about, supplementing. Alright, so anyway, look, critical think, people. Always question why and what's going on. Give your horse choices. It's freezing. I just moved my hands together and I hit the camera. It's not really that cold out here now. The sun's out. Little wind. I think it's like 26 or 27. And I don't know what the wind chill is, but the pond didn't freeze over. Their water that didn't have a heater is solid frozen. So Buddy came back, had a little snack. Now he's going to walk off and go see what Mr. T's eating. And I guess that's about it. It's a little bit nippy. My hands are getting cold. I'm going to go in. Smokey's sitting in by the fire. Everybody's like, where's Smokey? He's by that damn fire. As soon as he gets cold and I put that firewood in there, that cat's at this door like, dude, let me in. I know the fire's going. So he's laying down by the fire. I got a pork loin in the oven. I like to cook when it's cold because it helps heat the house. I figure if I'm going to heat up the house, I might as well do it when it's cold. So I had a pork loin in the refrigerator waiting for today because I knew it was going to be really cold. It's not getting out of the 20s all day. So I was like, you know what? I'll throw that in the oven and I'll help heat the house while I'm cooking. All right. So we'll end out there on horses and feeding and grazing, all kind of crazy stuff. I don't know what the hell I talked about. I don't even know what I'll name this damn thing. All right. We'll end out there. Buddy, right there, you good boys. Buddy's like, what? Did he say carrot? All right, well, in that there. I figured I'd let you guys say hi to Moki at the end of this. Fireplace. Moki with his nice little soft blanket that he likes. Smokey. With his little blankie. There's Smokey Cat with his little blankie. And the fireplace. And Smokey. All right.